Hey YouTube friends, Survivalcraft here. You may recognize this small yellow flower and its white puffball friend that you find around your yard. This is the dandelion. Now dandelion comes from the French dent de lion, which means lion's tooth. And the way it got that name was because of its toothy leaves. They almost look like a lion's teeth. Now you probably know the dandelion best as that weed you try to kill out of your nice lawn, but the dandelion has at least one medicinal use and a bunch of nutritional value. The one medicinal use of the dandelion I know of is you can use the dried leaves in a tincture as a laxative. But the dandelion is much more useful as a food. The dandelion was a staple of the ancient Romans. They would eat everything. They'd eat the roots, the leaves, the stem, and the flower. Starting from the bottom up, you can take the root and you can eat it raw, or you can dry it, grind it up, and use it as a coffee extender because it's really bitter. The younger leaves are really good for use raw in a salad, and the older leaves can be blanched almost like spinach. As for the flower head, you can take the flower head right off and eat it raw, or you can take it and put it in an infuser and use it to make dandelion tea. The two things, though, that I recommend are, number one, when you go to make the tea, take the green stuff off the bottom of the flower head. And the reason is because if you don't, it's fairly bitter. And the second thing is, when you go to make your tea, don't get the water very hot. Just make it kind of warm and let it seep. And that way you're not going to kill the vitamins A and C that are natural to the dandelion. Now, other people will take the dandelion heads and they'll make dandelion wine, or they'll dip them in batter and they'll make like little dandelion fritter things. I've not tried either of those. Someday I hope to, at least the fritter things. I don't know if I'd be fond of dandelion wine, but once I do, I'll post a video and share with you guys how it is. One last thing to note, though, the stem has a lot of natural latex. So if you have a latex allergy, then you probably need to avoid the dandelion altogether, because if that latex gets into contact with your skin, it's going to cause contact dermatitis. Otherwise, if you're not allergic to latex, I do recommend getting out and trying this weed. It's actually pretty tasty compared to some other weeds, and it has a lot of nutritional value, such as vitamin A and C, which I already covered, but it also has fiber and iron. If you have any questions, comments, suggestions, gripes, complaints, please put them in the comment section below. I'd love to hear from you guys. Also, if you would, please share, like, and subscribe. And as always, thank you guys for watching, and have a great day.